Hey guys, TechTimmy here. So in this video, I am going to be doing an unboxing, setup, and review of the Aura Mason Digital Photo Frame, and we're gonna do it right now. So without further ado, let's get into the unboxing. All right, so full disclosure, I did a different unboxing of this guy a while back, upwards of a year ago, and honestly, I have not had time to set it up and take it out of the box until now. So shame on me for doing that. I'm excited about getting this set up in my living room. I've just been so busy that I just have not had time to actually do the configuration. So in this video, we're gonna take care of that piece as well as the unboxing. We'll do a full setup, and then I'll also give you my initial impressions in the form of a mini review. So without further ado, let's take it out of the box for the second time here. So Aura, and yeah, I haven't even done the peel. I'll actually link to my unboxing video somewhere here. I'll put up a card on the screen if you guys are interested in checking out the more thorough unboxing. And this one, we'll get through the unboxing quick and jump right into the setup, which I suspect is why many of you are here. So let's get that solid peel done. Happiness starts here indeed. And there we go. And interestingly, so there's a little bit of film left on the outside of the frame, which presumably we can wipe that off easily enough. So that's that. And then, so beautiful looking product. This is the Pebble, I believe it's Pebble color. The frame itself is gray. I was a little bit confused about what Pebble meant before, but it's definitely gray. It's a nice sort of dark gray undertone with this sort of recessed look of little, we'll call them little sparkly things, little white things in there. And then just to make sure that, I just wanna make sure, yeah, so. That's not going to be a problem whatsoever. I would use will use a cleaning cloth to clean this in a little bit, and we'll try and keep the lighting out of there. So let's get that out of the way. And yeah, the lighting, I didn't love the lighting in the last video. I think it's because of these overhead lights here. In fact, I'm going to turn those off right now. Hold on. So that's much better. So I just have my regular lighting now. So hopefully that will look a little better, and we don't have mad reflections in the lighting up there. You can see my light up there. So, okay, so that's that. So documentation it looks really good and solid. This is straightforward enough to set up. We're really not gonna have to belabor this. Where I think it'll be helpful is if you intend on giving this as a gift, which you can gift this and then actually send photos to, let's say your mother or grandma or whatever, you can send the photos wirelessly to their frame. So even if they live on the other side of the country, and potentially even on the other side of the world, just as long as they have good Wi-Fi, you can send photos over to their frame, which is awesome. I'm a technical writer by trade, so good on Aura for doing such a great job with this document. It looks outstanding, and I love the fact that the type isn't small. Somebody actually really thought this through, multiple languages and so forth, but it's a fantastic guide, so good on them for doing that. Also, I will say, this is not a sponsored video, but Aura did send me this frame to test, and all opinions are my own. We're gonna, you know, we'll give a completely honest assessment, but for everything I've seen so far, this just looks very, very cool. Oh yeah, this is the outer wrapper for the thing, and then the cord is also like really well done. The engineering on this thing I absolutely love. So two things here. So I believe this connector is brilliant in that it sits in the back without any sort of recessing or whatever. So if you want to put this up against the wall, you can, and it'll do fine. And the other thing is, you've got a two-prong plug here. So I have sort of old school outlets in my apartment, and invariably I will hook this up to either a power brick or whatever. I just really think that it's cool that they thought of that. So the two-prong adapter is great. And then we have ample cord, and the cord itself is like this rope material. So also a very cool aesthetic there. I just think it's just all around brilliant on their part. And then in the rest of the box, there's nothing else. So that is essentially it. So you get the document, the frame itself, the cool wire, and basically that's it. So yeah, and then so here. So let's just put this here so you guys can see. I don't like showing those lights up the top there for some reason. So there's the cord, and then we have all of our lovely documents here. Again, documentation on this guy is outstanding. And then it's basically the box. So that's what you get. And so, yeah, so let's get into the setup next. So I am going to move over to the app next. So if you haven't downloaded the Aura app yet, that's the next step here. And so we're going to go ahead and get that installed, and then we will walk through the setup process step by step, hopefully to make this as painless as possible for you guys. So let's go over onto the app right now.
Whoop. All right, so here I am in the trusty App Store, and I just basically typed Aura Frames at the top. That's the name of the app. So basically, when that comes up, you just want to click on the Get button and then click Install. All right, very straightforward there. And then once it's installed, you basically just want to open it. So click the Open button. And here we are in the Aura app. So it's going to ask us to create an account, which is super easy. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. And I'm just going to block out my email address. After you get your email in there, you just want to click on the Create Account button. And that brings up this screen where it has to be a first name, which is kind of cool. It just has to be a first name, not your last name. I like that. And then we basically want to enter a relatively strong password. I don't think too many people are going to be trying to hack your Aura app, but yeah, I'd say just, you know, go with whatever the recommendations are for password and just go ahead and create that. And then you want to click on the little checkbox that it says you read the privacy policy and so forth. And when that's done, you want to click on create account, obviously. And it's going to create our account. And so here we are. You have the option to add a profile photo. I think I'm going to skip that for now. So I'm going to click on skip. And then, yeah, so then we're ready to set up the frame. Very cool. So I'm just going to select it's for me. If you were giving this as a gift to someone else, you would want to select that option. But for me, this is just my frame. I'm going to keep it here. So we're going to click on the top radio button there. And then we want to allow Aura to use Bluetooth, of course. And then, so now we need to go and plug in the frame. So I'm going to go over to the frame and do that.
So here we are. I was instructed to plug in the frame. So that's exactly what we're doing here in this next step. And I'm going to try and make this video as complete as I can for you guys. So I'm plugging it into my power source here, and it looks like it is firing up. So I see this little circle in the middle of the screen that was not there before. It is powering up. So as we can see, we have some activity. The little circle there is doing its little dance here in the center of the frame. And presumably this is going to go on in just a tick. And now it's getting brighter. It's probably a good sign. And there we go. Okay, so I have it upside down. Oh, wait, no, it's going to correct its orientation for me automatically, which I love. So not sure who that girl is, but presumably excitement, surprise, delight, captivate. Very cool. So presumably we need that code to enter into the app. So next I'll switch back over to the app so we can do that step.
Okay, so here we are now back in the app, and basically we want to hit the it's powered on button. I think you need to do that in order to enter the code, and indeed. So interestingly, the code here, 2591, you might remember, is the same code that was on the frame itself. So no need to actually enter anything, which is kind of neat. And then so here we just want to click on next, and then it's going to verify our Wi-Fi connection, I believe, and have us select our Wi-Fi network. Yep. And then so here my Wi-Fi network is called Tatooine. So I'm going to select that one. Notably, that's my 2.4 gigahertz network. I also have a network called Coruscant that's 5 gigahertz that didn't appear. So it looks like it will only work with 2.4 gigahertz networks. And then it's going to have us enter our Wi-Fi password. I'll block that out also in the video, and then it's going to go ahead and connect. Fingers crossed. Let's see what we got here. And indeed, so very cool. So next step is here. Was the frame a gift? Blah, blah, blah. So we're just going to skip this one. It was not. Well, technically it was a gift from Aura. So thank you, Aura, but we're still going to skip this step. So we'll just click on the skip radio button there. And then I think we should be good to add photos. Yeah, here we go. So, okay. So to add photos, we basically want to click on the little plus sign down there, and it's going to say, you know, allow access to all photos for your camera roll on your phone, which is great. And then, so I am not going to go through and show you guys all the photos on my phone. I have my kids on there and so forth. So I think I'll fast forward through this part. I'll add a few photos that are like landscapey type photos, whatever, and we'll see what it looks like. So great. So I went through and I added I think it was 8 photos to the frame. And now it after you add some photos, it wants you to name the frame. So I'm gonna just change this to be Tech Timmy's frame. Why not? Right? This is Tech Timmy's channel after all. Okay. And now might be a good time to say, if you're not subscribed to the channel, I'd appreciate it if you would. And then please give the video a thumbs up if this is helping you. Thank you. Okay, so invite friends and family to collaborate. So here I'm also going to skip this step. I may actually share this with my sister at some point, but for now we're just going to go ahead and say next here, and it's going to go ahead and add my 8 photos, hopefully. Now get notified when your photos get loved. Oh, that's cool. Okay, so allow notifications. And that way, if any friends and family or whatever happen to like a particular photo, presumably it will send you a notification to your phone. And then just some features here: unlimited photos, slideshow order, slideshow timing, on and off, based on the brightness of the room. Okay, interesting. So it is automatic, the power mode. I like that as well. And then a touch bar control we will look at in a second together. And then yeah, so here we go. Okay, so these are the 8 photos that I selected. I selected some photos from my hometown here in the Hunt, and a couple of Florida pictures as well, it looks like. So before we go and look at how this is playing out on the frame itself, I wanted to just go through some of the settings real quick. So basically, I want to click that cog in the upper right to access the settings. And then here we are. So yeah, so lots of things you can adjust here. So the timing is sort of a key one, and I think I'm going to actually set mine to be 2 hours. I feel like 10 minutes is a little bit too quick to be switching up the photos every 10 minutes, at least initially, at least until I get the thing really loaded up with all my photos. So yeah, 4 hours, 2 hours. Yeah, let's go with 2 hours, at least initially. But the nice thing is you can come back in here and change this up as often as you'd like in terms of, switching it up. You can even go all the way down to 15 seconds to, to switch up your photos, which is cool. So you can also select a background, whether or not you want it black or filled. It does this blurring effect. If you have portrait photos, it will you can modify the background that way. And there's a whole bunch of settings here. You can actually even adjust the speaker volume, presumably if you upload videos. And auto, you can have an autoplay, the photo order, you can have a shuffle, you can actually do it. So that would be random. You can actually do it in a set order if you want as well. So very, very cool. Some email features and everything else. So yeah, so let's go see where the magic happens. We'll go over to the frame and see how this is all playing out there.
Yeah, so here we are looking at the Aura frame, and indeed it did load up my photos. Super easy to do using the app. And there's just a few additional swipe and tap features here that we can look at on the top. But so the first one is if you just tap, it'll give you basic details in terms of the photo. So this was taken in the Hunt, Mass, where I live, and the date of the photo and who it was shared by and so forth. Very cool. And it also says long press on the top. Let me show you something else first. So if you swipe across, that's how you switch to the next photo. So if you don't want to wait the 2 hours or 10 minutes or whatever time frame you set this up for, it's as easy as that to do. And look at that. So there's one of the picture that I took from a recent trip to Fort Lauderdale. And then here's another picture of lovely Nahant, the beach near me. And then here's another photo, not far from where I live and so forth. So yeah, so very cool. And then so it says loading photos. So that's interesting. I wasn't expecting that. But then oh, there we go. So there's just another picture of the city. So it's taking it's sort of trying to it's loading the photos in, and it may take a minute for them to process, but I mean it's as easy. I mean how simple is this thing? And then the other thing is long press on the top. So if you long press on the top, it will give you more options, which is close, exclude, and off. So exclude presumably means you want to, well, maybe let me do that right now. Okay, so let's long press on the top. Yeah, so I'm actually not really sure what. So close this menu. Okay. Yeah, so that I'm really not too sure how it works. It seems straightforward enough, and it could just be that the frame needs a little bit more time to load the images in, but you have all sorts of settings that you can adjust in the app. I don't really love that photo. That one's a little bit nicer, I guess, for to show on the video. But yeah, man, I mean, this is just so easy and intuitive to set up, and I absolutely love it. I am going to get rid of all of the old school photo frames that I have, and I'm gonna load this up with family and friends, and I might actually get a second one for the bedroom. I absolutely love this. So yeah, if you got any value from this video, if you wouldn't mind giving me a quick thumbs up, I appreciate it a lot. And in terms of mini review, I mean, you guys, there's not much more that I can say about this. Check out my unboxing video, because I do go over the box and some more details in terms of the specs, the size of the screen, and so forth. This is, I believe, 10.6 inch option. That might not be right, but I definitely have it right in the other video if you want to check out my unboxing video, where I actually go through the specs a little bit more. And please consider subscribing. I do all sorts more videos about tech. If you have any questions about this, or you have a specific question, you want me to do a follow-on video, I'm happy to do it. Just drop a comment down below, and yeah, hope to see you in the next video. Hope this helped, and cheers.